The three-coil DC motor is one of the most ingenious inventions in the electrical world. Its construction is so simple and unique that understand the working principle behind them will be a real fun. As usual, to learn about its inner workings, let's have a look at the 3D animation.
You can see that the two permanent magnets constitute the stator, while the rotor is a three-pole type. A single coil is used for the complete winding of the rotor. You can understand the winding details by following the current flow. The rotor coil is connected with three commutator rings, as shown. Each commutator ring sits between the coil pair. DC power is supplied to the commutator rings via a pair of brushes. Now let's get into its working. The working of this motor can be easily explained with the help of simple electromagnetic induction. This means that a coil carrying electricity will become an electromagnet, as shown. You can easily predict the direction of this electromagnet with the help of the right-hand thumb rule. Let's simplify the coil arrangement to make things a bit clearer, and begin with this position of the rotor. Assume that DC power is applied. Let's use the following notations to represent the three commutator rings and coils. At this position, the brushes are in connection with commutator rings 1 and 2. With this arrangement, current will flow in all three coils. Let's hide coil A in order to understand current flow in a better way. As you follow the coil, current will start from terminal 2, flow through coils B and C, respectively, and finally end up in commutator ring 1. If you check the current flow in coil A, you can easily predict that there will be a current flow, as shown. Now you can easily predict the magnetic polarity of each coil with the help of the right-hand thumb rule. Coils B and C become north in polarity, while coil A becomes the south pole. These electromagnets will interact with a permanent magnet now. The north and south poles will attract, while the north and north poles will repel, as shown. This will force the rotor to turn, as illustrated. However, as the rotor turns, the brushes come in contact with different commutator rings. This alters the whole rotor current flow, and this simple trick makes the rotor turn again. Let's see what happens in this configuration. In the new configuration, the negative terminal is connected to the commutator rings 1 and 3 together. So rings 1 and 3 possess the same voltage. Since coil C is connected between these rings, there will not be any current flow through coil C. Let's omit this coil. Current flow occurs in the remaining two ring coils, as shown. Here, coil A acts as the south pole, whereas coil B acts like the north pole. Due to the forces of attraction and repulsion, the rotor will turn. As the rotor turns, the brushes come in contact with different commutator rings. The current flow in the coil thus changes again. This process is repeated, and we get continuous rotor rotation. It is amazing to see just how complex the operations of seemingly simple engineering devices truly are. Would you like to build your own DC motor at home? Please check out this video. Your support at patreon.com is what allows Learn Engineering to continue going strong. We thank you in advance for your support.